good and evil are the constructs of human beings. So how would evil karma affect our life when it is a concept that we have defined?
Yes, not it doesn't. It's a good thing to explore these things. I have touched on this before, but I'll touch on it again. How do you define good and evil, good or bad? How do you define it? Very simple. This is a, learn it is a very powerful way of understanding the idea of good and evil in your own life or in our own lives. Anything that takes you back to your true nature, not the jivatman but the atman, is good. Anything that takes you away from your true nature is bad, evil. Simple as that. So wow, as simple as that. So when you now analyze your own life and say, now I set up this action, I did the action with this intention, but then things worked out wrongly, what has happened, good or bad, etc. Is it good, evil, good karma, bad karma? Answer is very simply, if your intention was to link up with your true nature of the spirit in that process, saying, I see myself reflect other human beings suffering, I'm doing something for him. If that is the attitude, you are done perfectly well. You're going towards your true nature, so it's good. Doesn't matter what the result is. So the anything that is taking you back to your true nature is considered good. Anything taking you away from your true nature is bad. It's a very beautiful, know the tradition has got this simple, lovely way of explaining good and bad or good and evil. Or say, all this karma I said, I just, by the way, your intention saying you're going back to your true nature, any activity that takes me to my true nature, good. Full stop. Doesn't matter what results follows. That is a good effect you either. Don't be frightened.